everybody, and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how to crochet the very fast and absolute classic V-stitch. I'm also going to show you how to change colour and how to deal with these pesky ends. To begin, we're going to start by popping a slip knot onto our hooks. Now, the pattern multiple for the V-stitch is a nice, simple 3. All that means is you are going to chain 3, 3, 3, 3 for as wide as you want your project to be. I'm just going to be making a very small sample today, so I'm going to go ahead and chain 21. Now we're going to work into the fourth chain from our hooks. Now this loop on your hook does not count as anything. You only want to count these fully formed chains hanging down below. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And into this fourth chain, we're going to work our first V-stitch. Now the V-stitch is formed with a double crochet. Chain one, and another double crochet worked right back into that very same chain. You can identify it by it being stretched up from where you've just worked into it. Pop another double crochet into that same chain. And that forms a little V. Double crochet, chain one, double crochet. Now skip two chains. And into the next, work another V-stitch, which is double crochet, chain one, double crochet, all into the same chain. Double crochet, chain one, double crochet. Skip two chains, 1, 2, and work a V-stitch into the next chain. We're going to do this all the way along. Once you get over to the other side, you will notice you only have two chains left. There's no more room to skip two chains and place another V-stitch. So how we end is with a double crochet into that very last chain. If you were using the same color, you can go ahead and just complete your double crochet into that last chain as normal. However, we're going to be changing color. And how we do that is in this very last stitch. So we're going to start the double crochet. So yarn over and go into that very last chain. Draw up a loop, 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through the first 2. Then bring in your new color. And we're going to place a loop over the hook. leave a decent tail for weaving in, and you're going to draw that through those final two loops. So you have changed colour right in that very last stitch. You can now go ahead and cut your yellow yarn. Again, leave a decent long tail so you can weave it in. And now you're ready to begin row two. Now row two is the pattern repeat row. All that means is we're simply going to repeat row two over and over and over again until your project is the size you want it to be. So for row two, we're going to chain two and turn your work. Now look to spot your V stitches from the row below. After this second row, they will become a lot more apparent. So pay careful attention on this first one that we're doing here. The V stitch is identified by these two double crochets with that chain one in between. Not these spaces either side of it, this V in the middle. We're going to work our stitches into the chain one space in between your V stitches of the row below. So ignoring these bottom chain spaces and working into this middle section here, work your V-stitch, which is double crochet, chain one, double crochet, back into that same place. So your V-stitch is worked into the V-stitch from the row below. And then immediately leap into your next V-stitch here. Remember, ignore these bottom spaces. You're working into these top chain one spaces. Straight into there, pop another V-stitch. Double crochet, chain one, double crochet. Keep working this V-stitch into the top of your V-stitches from the row below, all the way along. So you can see all your V-stitches line up with your V-stitches from the row below, giving this zigzag type effect. Now to end the row, we're going to work into the turning chain from the row below. So identify your last stitch, which will have a little V like this, and work into the chain next to it. And into the top of that chain, we're going to place a double crochet. Now again, I'm going to change color halfway through the stitch, but if you're not, you just complete your double crochet without messing about with changing yarn. So yarn over and into the top of that chain, pop your hook in. You've got your three loops. And then when you are about to complete the stitch, bring in your new color. Again, leave a nice tail. Draw it through. Then trim your purple end. Again, leave your tails. It's very important to weave in the tail securely, and you want a nice length to be able to go quite a way into the blanket. Then from this point on, it is simply a case of repeating row two. So chain two, turn your work, and you should be able to spot your V stitches all stacking up neatly, and into each chain one space of the V-stitch of the row below, you're going to work a new V-stitch. Do this all the way along, V-stitch into the top of the V-stitches from the row below. Once you reach the end of your row and you have finished your final V-stitch, end with a double crochet into the top chain of your turning chain for the row below. Change color if you are changing color, or if this is your very last stitch and you have repeated row two over and over and over and you are ready to finish, do not change color, finish your stitch as usual, chain one, cut your yarn, and pull that through the loop and pull it tight, ready to tackle these ends. Now I've just brought in the blanket that I'm currently working on so you can see all these horrendous tails waiting to be woven in. Now you have a couple of options here. The first option is you could knot these together and add tassels to have a fringed edge. I have a video on how I did that on my moss stitch scarf on how to finish that, which will have popped up over here if you want to go and have a look about how to add tassels to cheat your way and never weave in another end. Or another way is to knot these ends together with a gentle little knot. Make sure you are catching every end, just knotting them together in pairs, like so. You don't want to pull them too tight because if you pull too tight, you will pucker the stitches. So just knot them gently, then grab a large eye needle, thread up one of these tails, and we're going to run it through the corresponding color. Now this is a pale pink, which is this row here, and I'm simply going to go up and into that row, so I am in the correct row, and I'm going to weave this end in and out of my stitches so that it is hidden and invisible. I'm just going through the stitch and I'm going to follow my V stitches back and forth, up and down along the row, just going into the stitch itself and then back down the other one. You want to secure these ends nicely because as a blanket gets used and thrown in the washing machine and as it gets moved about like this, these little ends will start to work their way out, which is why it's good to leave a nice long tail. If you ever see a little end poking out, you can just snip the end, secure in the knowledge that you've got a good few inches woven in back along and the whole thing isn't going to unravel. So it is definitely worth taking your time on this step just to ensure these ends are thoroughly in. Once you're happy with how far along, so you can see I've come through quite a few stitches with that end, and as I pull it around, it's got a lot of give, it's not going to go anywhere. Once you're happy with how that is woven in, you can just snip that little end off, and as I say, over time, if that were to work out, you see how when I'm pulling it, it's kind of creeping back. I'm being fairly rough and dramatic here to show you. Over time, little ends may sneak out, but that's okay because you know how much you've woven in. You can just, oh, I've lost it. Oh, there it is. You can just snip them off if they bother you. There we go. And that is how you crochet the very classic V-stitch, how to change color, and how to weave in your ends. If you found this video helpful, it would be great if you could give me a thumbs up. And until next time, happy crocheting. Bye.